Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Today we're talking about performance upgrades and modifications for the Duramax LMM. The LMM is Duramax's first true emissions diesel with the addition of DPF system and regeneration, but fortunately, it can still produce some pretty good power levels with just some basic bolt-on modifications. Just tuning an intake, some exhaust upgrades, and an intercooler can pretty easily get you a relatively reliable 500 wheel horsepower on the Duramax LMM. Pushing beyond 500 is where things start to get very expensive and you're gonna have to start looking at some more advanced modifications. And so in this video, we're just gonna go ahead and cover these basic bolt-on modifications, but I will talk a little bit about engine power levels and at what power levels you'll need to start looking at some more advanced upgrades. And then I'll throw in a couple bonus mods at the end as well. So first, let's go ahead and talk about engine power limits. The first recommendation to support your fueling system is gonna be a lift pump. A lift pump is recommended immediately on the LMM. With a lift pump, your injectors are good until about 525 to 550 wheel horsepower, and your CP3 injection pump is good for 600 plus wheel horsepower. So with a lift pump, you don't have to worry about your fueling system at all until you start talking about getting into the 500 plus range. The first limitation that you're gonna run into, as is also true with any Duramax, is gonna be your Allison 1000 transmission. The transmission's good for about 450 to 500 wheel horsepower. Transmission tuning is definitely recommended for 450 wheel horsepower plus. 500 plus wheel horsepower is when you'll need to look at transmission upgrades or getting a built transmission. The factory turbocharger is good for about 525 wheel horsepower. You might be able to get 550 if you put it on a very aggressive max effort tune. And then the last engine limit that you'll want to be aware of is the pistons. The pistons are prone to cracking and snapping at about 600 wheel horsepower. So 600 wheel horsepower is the maximum limit of this engine without breaking into it and doing some internal upgrades. So ultimately, the LMM can pretty reliably get to 450 wheel horsepower. It can get up to 500 wheel horsepower reliably as well. You'll just want to think about your transmission and definitely at least add transmission tuning at that level. The one thing that I will mention is that the emission systems on the LMM are known to be problematic, as we discussed in our LMM common problem video. So as you add power and performance, you are going to increase the likelihood that you run into issues with things like your DPF and your EGR cooler and things like that. With all that being said, let's go ahead and jump into our bolt-on modifications here. The first thing that we recommend is a lift pump. So with that one out of the way, now we're good to add tuning. Tuning is really where all of your big power gains are gonna come from. You have a couple different options here. If you want to really dial things in, get custom tuning and look at transmission tuning as well, then you'll wanna stick with an EFI-based tuning solution like HP Tuners or EFI Live. But if you're just looking to add some small power gains, you aren't planning on taking things far into the 450, 500 plus range, then you can opt for a more budget handheld programmer that just has some canned tunes on it. And for that, I recommend the PPE standard accelerator, which costs about $450 compared to spending $1,000 or $1,200 on EFI Live and potentially more once you start looking at transmission tuning as well. But those two are gonna be the best tuning solutions. They're just not necessarily required if you plan on putting things in the 400, 450 wheel horsepower range. With proper tuning, you can get a ton of power out of these engines. So the rest of the modifications on this list here aren't necessarily to add additional power, because tuning can get you there. It's more so to optimize the efficiency of your engine and the reliability of your engine when it's tuned. For that, my first recommendation is a cold air intake. Once you add tuning and you're running higher boost levels, it's really helpful for the turbocharger to bring that additional airflow in. It's gonna help take some stress off the turbocharger, improve its efficiency, which is gonna help it run a little bit cooler, improve its reliability, which will ultimately result in lower EGTs and engine temperatures. While some people say you don't need an intake until you start talking about 500 wheel horsepower plus, there's definitely still some benefit to doing it ahead of time, and you might even get some fuel economy gains out of it as well, which will help pay for itself. After an intake, I recommend an exhaust exhaust system. There are a couple different options here. You have upgrading the downpipe and then upgrading the DPF or catback portion of the exhaust system. That's gonna be the safest way to keep all of your emission system intact and still give you a good reduction of back pressure and exhaust gas temperatures. A downpipe is gonna be a little bit more important than the catback portion, just since the downpipe is bolted directly to the turbocharger. And so that's gonna have the biggest reduction in EGTs and exhaust back pressure, but it's still definitely good to upgrade the catback portion as well. If you don't have or don't need the emissions equipment, then getting a turbo back option is ultimately gonna be the best from both a performance, reliability, and EGT and back pressure reduction standpoint. Head on over to Boosted Performance. We actually sell a downpipe for the LMM. It's a great option to keep your factory emissions equipment and still get some good EGT reductions. And we also have some exhaust systems and other bolt-on modifications available there as well. So now with tuning an intake in an exhaust system, my last recommended upgrade is a little bit more of a recommendation than a requirement, and that's gonna be an upgraded intercooler. An upgraded intercooler is really gonna be one of the best reliability modifications that you can do. It's not a huge power adder, but it is a performance upgrade in the sense that it is going to help you prevent heat soak. It's going to allow for more consistent performance, but most importantly, it's going to give you the reliability benefits by pushing colder air into the engine and lowering your engine temps and your exhaust gas temperatures as well. This really isn't needed until the 500 plus wheel horsepower range, but regardless of what power levels you're at, regardless of if you're tuned or not, if you do a lot of heavy towing or you do a lot of more aggressive driving, an intercooler is absolutely worth it from both a performance, but more importantly, from a reliability standpoint. The downside is just that intercoolers are very expensive to upgrade. You're probably looking at $1,000+ for a full kit, but if you can afford it, it is still one of the best modifications that you can do reliability-wise. So that covers my basic list of bolt-on modifications here. Those four upgrades in intercooler, exhaust, intake, and tuning will give you a pretty good setup. It'll allow you to add some decent power, but not push things to a limit where you're gonna start breaking things and need a lot more expensive upgrades. There are a couple other things that you can do if you want to really optimize the efficiency of your engine, reduce all airflow restrictions, and maximize your efficiency and reliability with all of these modifications as well. And that's gonna be upgrading the Y-bridge, the up pipes, and the intercooler piping as well. Those are a couple things that aren't required at these power levels, but again, if you've got some additional money and you're really just looking to maximize efficiency and reliability, then those are worthwhile things to look into as well. Anyways, guys, that covers it for performance upgrades for the Duramax LMM. If you appreciate this video, please click that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for our future Duramax content.